Londen naar van die Australische toerspan zijn eerste...
the thing on that.
Yeah.
with me because he needs clear from my certain limb. Wouldn't it be weird if you come here and I just had to take the 2,000 movies?
Those of you who've got seats, please be seated. God lives in them. Let us pray. Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name through Christ our Lord. Amen. Can you all hear me at the back?
Yeah.
If you can't at any stage, just wave. We are gathered here in the presence of God to celebrate the wedding of Ian and Debbie, to rejoice with them and to support them with our prayers. Marriage is a gift and calling of God, is not to be entered into lightly or thoughtlessly, but reverently, responsibly, in obedience to the gospel of Christ. God has provided marriage for the companionship of help and comfort in mutual care, that husband and wife may live faithfully together. God has provided it for the fulfilling of human love in mutual honor, that husband and wife may know each other with delight. God has provided it for the birth and nurture of children, so that they may find the security of love and grow up in the heritage of faith. God has provided marriage for the enrichment of society, that husband and wife being joined together may enter into the life of the community as a new creation. Debbie and Ian now come to give their free consent and to exchange their vows of faithfulness to each other for the whole of their life together. Do you, Walter Ian Raynor Hogg, declare that as far as you know, there is no lawful impediment to your proposed marriage with Deborah Jean Cox here present, and that you call all here present to witness that you take Deborah Jean Cox as your lawful wife?
I do.
Do you, Deborah Jean Cox, declare that as far as you know, there is no lawful impediment to your proposed marriage with Walter Ian Raynor Hogg here present, and that you call all here present to witness that you take Walter Ian Raynor Hogg as your lawful husband?
I do.
Let us pray. Our loving Father God, we ask that as Ian and Debbie take the vows of marriage, they may be conscious of your presence, as aware of you as they are of each other, as they are of ourselves. Help them to be true to each other. Bless the giving and receiving of the ring, symbol of unending love, reminder of the vow and the covenant to be made this day. We ask this for your love's sake. Amen. Ian, will you take Debbie as your wife in Christian marriage? Will you love her, comfort her, honor and protect her in times of prosperity and health, in times of trouble and suffering, and be faithful to her as long as you both shall live?
I will.
Debbie, will you take Ian to be your husband in Christian marriage? Will you love him, comfort him, honour and protect him in times of prosperity and health, and in times of trouble and suffering, and be faithful to him as long as you both live?
Mm-hmm.
Who gives the bride away? I call upon these persons here present.
That I, Ian,
do take thee, Debbie,
to be my lawful wedded wife.
In accordance with God's holy will.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward. For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
And to this end.
I pledge my word. I call upon these persons here present.
To witness that I, Debbie.
Do take thee, Ian. To be my lawful wedded husband. In accordance with God's holy will. To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
For better, for worse.
For richer, for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Till death us do part.
And to this end.
I pledge my word. Debbie, I give you this ring.
In God's name.
As a symbol of all that we have promised.
And all that we shall share.
Ian, I receive this ring.
In God's name.
As a symbol of all that we have promised.
And all that we shall share.
Debbie and Ian have declared before God and before you that they will live together in Christian marriage. They have made sacred promises to each other and have symbolized their marriage today by joining hands and by the giving and receiving of a ring. I therefore pronounce them to be husband and wife in the name of God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. What God has joined together, man must not separate. May the Lord bless you and take care of you. The Lord be kind and gracious to you. The Lord look on you with favor and give you peace. Amen. We have a brief reading from Scripture. The New Testament. The first letter of Paul to the church in Corinth from chapter 13. If I speak in the tongues of men and of angels but have not love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains but have not love, I am nothing. If I give all I possess to the poor and surrender my body to the flames but have not love, I gain nothing. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It is not rude. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. Love keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Love never fails. But where there are prophecies, they will cease. Where there are tongues, they will be stilled. Where there is knowledge, it will pass away. For we know in part and we prophesy in part. But when perfection comes, the imperfect disappears. When I was a child, I talked like a child, I thought like a child, I reasoned like a child. When I became a man, I put childish ways behind me. Now we see a poor reflection, then we shall see face to face. Now I know in part, then I shall know fully, even as I am fully known. And now these three remain: faith, hope, and love. But the greatest of these is love. Let's join together in prayer again. Let us pray. God our Father, you have given Ian and Debbie grace to see each other in this special night of love. May your love in Christ deepen their love and bring them through life, bearing each other's burdens, sharing each other's joys. Bless their families and friends. May they always thank you for them. Bless their home together. May they welcome both friends and strangers to it. Bless them in the gift of children, that they may be loving, wise, and caring parents. Father God, we thank you that in our earthly life you speak to us of eternal life. May Debbie and Ian know you more clearly, love you more dearly, follow you more nearly, day by day, through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Now may the God of hope keep you in all good peace in his grace. In the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God the Father, the fellowship of the Holy Spirit, be with you forever. Friends, we're going in a matter of seconds just here for the signing of the register. Please, during that time, would you remain there as you are. Trying to look happy. Thank you.
And how if we head to under that frangipani tree?
You don't think it's too wet? No, inside. I think outside.
Oops, sorry.
Yeah, I think so.
Keep it going, please.
Two drops of water.
Ladies and gentlemen, I've been asked to propose a toast to the bride and the groom. This gives me great pleasure, as Debbie and Ian have been good friends to us ever since we came to this country 4 years ago. They went out of their way to make us welcome and feel at home. Since then, we've done a variety of things together. We're just good friends. We've done sailing, camping, riding bikes. I believe there's quite a few motorbike riders here today, so a couple of stories of their exploits won't go amiss. I believe on Ian's first competitive ride, he took his tea and sandwiches with him, and halfway round stopped and had his tea and sandwiches. As for Debbie, well, Debbie's first ride on a motorbike, gosh, she tried to climb on the wall and pick and pay. Debbie and Ian are very useful people too, with Ian being a dental surgeon and Debbie being a clinical psychologist. They can look both after your dental health and your mental health. And it's also a great pleasure that I welcome Ian's parents, Donald and Brenda, from Scotland for the wedding. I'm only sorry that Debbie's father could not have lived to see his daughter married today. I think it's a splendid idea to have the wedding in the garden here. In such pleasant surroundings. It's a shame about the weather though. I know Debbie and Ian have worked so hard on this garden, getting it ready in time for the wedding. And I'm sure there's a lot more plans for this place yet. Finally, I would just like to reiterate that it has given me great pleasure to count them as my friends, and I wish them every success in the future. I'm sure everything they turn their hand to will be successful. Now, if everyone has a glass, would you all join me in drinking a toast to the bride and groom?
The bride and groom.
Debbie and Ian.
Debbie and Ian.
good fellows.
We're jolly good fellows.
Yes, ladies and gentlemen, it's my turn now. I have in fact arranged a little crib sheet. So I think it's just about useless because I wrote it out this afternoon and I've been told so many things I've missed out. I might as well throw it away. But first of all, let me thank Debbie's mum. I think Debbie's mum, especially for such a beautiful bride, and for all the other things that she's done. She's organised the reception. She's had all the beautiful flowers, which I think she must have stolen from all the private gardens in Portchester. And for the cake, I must admit, it's a magnificent cake. Now, Debbie's mum, thank you very much. And then we come to the next one. Both my parents. Where are they? Hiding. They might be vaguely embarrassed, but no, they're here. They very kindly come out to this wedding, all the way from Scotland. They came for Christmas and for New Year. I think they've had a reasonable time, but they've been very, very helpful in organising the whole thing today. So thank you to my parents. Right, let's see what's next. Oh, the people who've organised the flowers. A lot of time and effort went into putting these flowers in today. Debbie's mum, Suzanne, Debbie's auntie Doreen, has spent a lot of time and effort putting these flowers in. I think you all have to admit they've done a very good job. Very impressive. Let's see what else we have. The caterers, Eleanor, who's supplied this magnificent spread. I hope you all enjoy it. Hope it's going to be enough. And also, may I say thank you to Debbie's parents, Lawrence, for giving Debbie away. And my friend Pete for the video. Alan de Villiers, who very kindly came here today to take pictures, even though he had a little bit of a disaster at home while he's away on holiday, the place was broken into. So I'm afraid Alan's here on his own. He doesn't have his wife with him, but Alan, thank you very much for coming. And the friends of mine who've come from quite a long way away, Annie and Mervyn, who made a special effort to leave the farm at this time of the year and come all the way, and a lot of other people who've gone through a great deal of time and effort to make themselves available to come here. And lastly, to my best man Stephen and all my friends who've really been real stars of organisation. May I thank everyone who's come and say that I'm very happy that you're here. A toast to everyone and especially a toast to my parents. Anyway, a toast to the parents. This is what it should be.
First one, Debbie and Ian. Now this is from Gwen and Jeff Calvert. This is all the way from Bulawayo. It says, best wishes for future happiness and love. Second telegram. This one is from Henri and Margaret Moscow from Harare. These are Debbie's relatives. Loving wishes for your happiness always. We have a message here that says lots of love and best wishes from Judy and Tony. I believe this is Debbie's sister and brother-in-law. Oh, this one's from Ian's Uncle Lou, which is from Epson in London. It says here, regrettably unable to attend, our hands are tied with baby number 3. Wishing you all of the best for the future, hope your hands aren't tied tonight. By the way, Ian's sister, Wendy, his second sister, Margaret and Dave, they phoned all the way from the UK this afternoon, and they wish Ian and Debbie all of the best. I think that was very nice of them. I'd like to make a toast to the bridesmaid, a very important person in Debbie's life over the last couple of weeks, I'm sure. I'd like to thank her for all her help. How many years? 28 years. That's quite a considerable difference in time. I must say, Manny's looking very good today. Please can we raise glasses and have a toast today? Finally, in closing, I'd like to thank Ian for asking me to be his best man. This, I feel, is a
well, he is enjoying it.
On the team.
Thank you.
Yes.
You have to come.
Oh,
yes.
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 Is it a real cake or?
Thank you.
Okay, please let's have as many of you as possible on the dance floor for this next one. Thank you.